Hey everyone, welcome to Photoshop Pro Help. Now today I'm going to be teaching this awesome text effect. Now the effect I'm going to be showing you has been made by someone else a couple of years ago. Now one of you guys has asked me to update this and put it into better quality. So here's the effect that you're going to be getting. Now this is the original picture of how it was filmed with Angelina Jolie, the original the look of it. Now this picture you can really have and really experiment with all different kinds of pictures. It works with a lot of things. Now I would say it works best with self-portraits on a white background. Now you can cut things out of images and put them onto white backgrounds, it works just as fine. So if I go over to this one here, this one I cut out and put onto a white background, still works just as fine as the original. So once you have loaded your image you want to apply this effect to into Photoshop, we can start work. So this is the original image here. If you do want to just follow me, you can download this image off my website. The link is going to be in the description bar for you to download. So first things first is we're going to go and unlock this image here. So as you can see the little padlock on the right hand side, we're just going to double click that layer and you'll get this new layer box come up. Click OK. Now that takes the padlocker out of it so we can edit it. Now from here all we're going to do now is go and select the shadows. So we're going to go up to select, going to go to color range, and we're going to go to the color range select, go down and click shadows. Now you want to make sure that you've got the selection clicked on and then click OK. Now all we're going to do now is a few commands on the keyboard, so Control and C and that's going to copy it, and Control and J and that's going to paste it onto a new layer for us. Now we're going to go back to layer 0 and we're going to go up to select, and we're going to go and select the midtones now. So go down to color range again, go to the color range select, and go to midtones. Make sure you've got selection clicked on, click OK. And from here we're going to go to Control and C, and then Control and J again. And as you can see, it's put onto a new blank layer on for us, and that's got the midtones. So we're going to hide layer 0 now. And you want to make sure you've got layer 2 selected. And we're going to go and fill this with 50% grey. So go up to edit, we're going to go to fill, and you want to go to the fill contents use drop down menu, go to 50% grey, make sure you've got preserve transparency clicked on, and then click OK. Going to go up to layer 1 and we're going to go back to edit, go to fill and go to the drop down menu again, go to black, make sure you've got preserve transparency clicked on again, and then click OK. Now once you have done this, all we're going to do is select the two layers, layer 1 and layer 2, and we're going to merge them together. So hold down Control on your keyboard and select layer 2 and layer 1, and then press right click and go to merge layers. Now as you can see, it's merged into layer 1. Now all we're going to do from here is we're going to go and get the brush that we're going to be using. So we need some text for this. Now you can have any text that you want, you can create anything you want, you can copy it off of a website if need be. So all we're going to do now is make a new blank document, but it has to be the same size as the document you're working with. So this picture here, we're going to go and find out the size. So you can go to image, image size. Now here's the width and the height we need for the new blank document. So you want to copy and paste these onto it. So I've already done that, so we can go to file, new, and mine's already come up, but you want to put yours here and then click OK. Now from here we're going to go and select the text icon which is on the left hand side, click that, and we're just going to go and click in the middle here where we need it. Now you can put any font that you want. I've gone for Lucid Calligraphy, and you want to change the size. Now depending on the size of your image that you're working with, it can go up and down, so you want to experiment. So I've gone for 36 for this, it should be fine. And I'm just going to go and copy this paragraph here. It's just a poem I found off a website. You can really have anything, you can have a poem or you can have or make your own, depending on what you want it to be about. So we're just going to go and Control and V to paste. So let's just change that to black. You want to make sure that the color is set to black for this, and that is a little bit too big. We're just going to drop down the size just there. So around about that will do for me. Just drop it down, put around about 24. Let's go for 29, should be okay, 28. There we go. Now, once you have got something like that, all we're going to do now is we're going to go up to the rectangle marquee tool. And we're going to go and select this. And then we're going to go to edit. We're going to go to define brush preset. And all this is going to do is make the text into a brush so we can use it. So you want to name your brush anything that you want and then click OK. Now I don't need to do that because I've already done mine. Now we're going to go back to the one we're working with. Now you want to make two blank layers. So we're going to go to the bottom right hand side, click the new blank layer icon twice. Now it's going to go to layer 2 and layer 3. You want to go to layer 2 and fill that with white. So go to the paint bucket tool or go to edit and fill. And we're just going to hide that. And then from here, all we're going to do now is go to layer 1. And we're going to do a few commands on the keyboard again. So Control and A, and that selects the whole of the image. And then Control and C. And what it does is it copies it. So we're going to go back up to layer 3 now. And what we're going to do is we're going to go and get our text, which we're going to go to the paintbrush tool. So there we go. And we're going to go up to the top and go to the drop down menu and go and select our text. Now, as I said, you really need to work with the size. So it really depends on what you need. So you can bring down the brush size. You want to change the brush sizes every time. So you want to go for a black with this, the color. And then we're just going to go along changing up the size every so often like that. And once you have done that, all we're going to do now is we're going to go and put a masking layer onto layer 3. So you want to go to the bottom right hand side and go to this little button here that looks like a camera, click that, and then hold down Alt and then click the new masking layer, which is there. So we make sure that we're working on that layer. So once you have got that, we're going to press Control and V, and what that does is paste what we've just copied, the original image. So we're just going to press now Control and D to deselect, and press Control and I to invert that. Now once you've done that, we're going to go back to the original image, the text image here, and all we're going to do now is we're just going to hide layer 1, and as you can see, we've got all the text here. Now it's not very bright, so we're going to turn on layer 2, and that makes it a lot more pungent. So all we're going to do now is apply a few layer styles. So we're going to double click that layer. That brings up the layer style. And we're going to go over to the gradient overlay, sorry. And you want to put the blend mode to screen. And you want to go and change the gradient editor. So I'm going to go for this one here, the blue, the red and the yellow. That's a preset. And I'm going to go click OK and click OK again. Now her face isn't really coming through, so all we're going to do now is go over to the paintbrush tool, go to the top, drop down menu, and we're going to go and select a soft brush, so this one here, and we're just going to scale the brush down to around about there. 200 will do probably. We're going to go for 125, and you want to make sure you've got black selected. You want to bring the opacity at the top 33%. And all we're going to do is we're just going to click and bring some of the details through. So just a jawline down here, like that, and a hair, like that, and just her lips and a bit of her nose. And there we have it. That's our image created. How easy was that? Now you've got a stylus image, you can really work with this, make it your own, put your own effects onto it. Now please comment, rate and subscribe. Please check out the website for other tutorials. And I'll see you next time, guys. Bye for now.